Now, a scam alert. A Jacksonville woman going to prison for taking part in a nationwide income tax scheme involving church pastors. She helped file thousands of false tax returns, seeking refunds totaling more than $9 million. She has been sentenced to 2.5 years in prison. The con was organized by a man in New Hampshire in 2011 who recruited 8 women that he called his angels. He made them file financial information that was false. Channel 4's Francesca Amaker has been digging deeper into this scam and spoke with an IRS special agent who says the crooks recruited pastors to help steal money from the IRS. Francesca?
They called themselves the Angels, 8 women from all over America working on a million-dollar scheme. The Angels worked under a man by the name of Craig Cudia, who recruited pastors from 8 states to solicit names, birth dates, and Social Security numbers from members of their congregation. The pastors were under the impression Cudia would help provide government stimulus funds to help the unemployed, disabled, and impoverished. But that information was passed along to his angels, one of which was Anne Marie Howard Aguiar from Jacksonville. She worked with Cudia from March to July of 2011.
He instructed the angels on what should be reported on the false tax returns and, you know, as far as income amounts, withholding, and expenses such as education and child care credits. And they went ahead and prepared and filed the returns to the IRS. And ultimately, refunds were issued for some of the returns that were filed.
Special Agent Amy Hosney says in fiscal year 2013, the IRS initiated 1,492 identity theft-related criminal investigations, an increase of 66% since 2012. Melissa Lee is also a special agent for IRS criminal investigation and says there are ways to make sure you don't fall victim to stolen identity refund fraud. Starting this year, Florida, Georgia, and the District of Columbia put a program in place where anyone who filed a tax return last year can request a 6-digit identity protection PIN through the IRS.
This extra layer of protection for you when filing a return. So it will be much more difficult for somebody to take your identity and file a return on your behalf, a fraudulent return. They need that number to input into the system before a return can be filed with your Social Security number and name.
Francesca Amaker, Channel 4, the local station.
Again, Aguiar was just arrested here in Jacksonville in February of last year. She has now begun serving more than 2 years in prison. Cudia committed suicide after learning that he was being prosecuted.